Today I'm going to be showing you how to make an animatronic hand using cardboard and a CD drive. For this tutorial, you will need some cardboard, a glue gun, a razor blade or cutting tool, you can also use scissors, some rubber bands. If you don't have rubber bands, zip ties will also do. Some craft beads, little beads with holes in them. If you don't have craft beads, you can actually use a straw. Some fishing line, and if you don't have fishing line like I do, I'm using it right now, you can use dental floss. And last but not least, you're going to want a CD drive. Just to quickly go over the design of the hand, so we have a piece of cardboard glued to the CD drive, and we have an external power cable that I actually hooked up to a timer, so every 15 minutes or so it would close it, but I made sure it wouldn't close all the way. These lines are taut, so it would automatically open up default. Then 15 minutes would go by and would do it again. We have dental floss going through the beads that are individually glued onto each finger, so when it pulls the drive closed, it actually pulls the fingers. And obviously this is what it looks like on this side. We begin by selecting a good piece of cardboard. I'm just going to use this section here, so I'm going to cut, maybe draw a thumb, and go from there. Now, since I've already made a left hand, I'm going to go ahead and try to make a right hand. It really doesn't matter because you're just going to flip the cardboard anyways, so I would measure out how you want to do yours, but since I've already made one, I'm just going to kind of do it freestyle. And then you're going to want to make some joints. And we're also going to cut some space in between each finger so they have some room to move. Now, I recommend using pencil, that way you can erase the lines when you're done. If you're going to paint it, you don't have to worry too much about it. Okay, now we're going to cut the fingers. What we're going to do is we're actually going to cut into the first layer of the cardboard so we can make little joints. As you can see, the cardboard's in layers. We don't want to go through the bottom layer, we just want to cut the top layer. Honestly, it'd probably be better to do this before cutting the fingers. And now we should be able to lightly bend each one at that point. And now we're just going to bend each point that we made a cut. These slits are to assist when it closes, that it actually makes a hand shape. Okay, so now to put little loops on each finger on the opposite side. Hand is going to bend like that. So we need something to secure the string on each finger. You can use craft beads, like I used on my first hand, or you can actually use a straw. So if you don't have craft beads or beads at home, you can literally just pick up a couple straws from wherever and cut them individually for each finger. So since I've done beads already, I'm actually going to use the straw, and I'm going to try to cut them all the same length here. It's not going to be perfect, and they're probably going to go all over the place. Not a single one is staying in place. There we go. I'm going to have to grab some of these. They really don't have to be that big, they just have to secure the line. And that should be enough. If not, I can resort to beads, because I only grabbed one straw this morning. Okay, so from here, we're actually going to start gluing them. I mean, cut them down if they need to be. Doesn't have to be perfect, you just want it kind of in the middle. And you don't want them to obscure the joint. So now we have straw bits on each individual finger. So when you bend, it should do that. Kind of check it. And now it's time to string them up. So now we're actually going to glue the hand to the CD drive. The reason we're doing this is when we string it up, we want to be able to put it right onto the door immediately. So, now, a lot of the times you're going to be dealing with a drive that's closed already. This little dot here by the indicator light, make sure that's not an indicator light. Some of the old ones have the same size light. You can actually take a pin or a paper clip and push right into it, and it will open the drive. Now that the drive is open, you can see that there's some space underneath and the door is closer to the top. So what we want to do is we want to put it as close to the hand as possible. So we're going to probably glue it somewhere around there. We want to make sure that it has enough room to pull the strings down. But we don't want to give it enough room to completely close, because then you have to either have software and a timer won't work. Now, you can use a computer for this. By all means, if you have a script or a piece of software that opens and closes your CD tray, you can actually use that to program when it opens and closes. Now, if you want to tape it to the drive, that's fine, but I'm just going to put a big old glop of glue here. Try to make sure it doesn't get into the tray, and then adhere it to our cardboard hand. Now we can flip it, try to center it as best we can before it completely dries. And we can start stringing it up. Now, this I may have to remove because I just realized that that's going to obstruct the string on this finger, because this is going to be pulling the thumb. So you may actually want to move it down here away from it, which I might end up doing, or I may just exclude the thumb altogether. Okay, well that's pretty good. It's interesting that it started to bend to cardboard here, so you may want to put a piece of support tape or something like that. And just to show everybody, I do have it all stringed up. I still need to cut some stray lines on here. But it is all threaded. And it does work. I left the thumb out. I put the string there just for cosmetic purposes. But the thumb really doesn't move. I didn't really string it up all that well, so I just kind of left it as is. As you can see, it twitches when it tries to close the door again, but it does work. And like I said, you can hook this up to a computer if you want, but you do need a script that opens and closes the CD tray. And the only scripts I could find that actually worked were Windows XP. If I find anything new, I'll show you by all means. But yeah, this is how to make a roughly about 1 hour build cardboard animatronic hand. I mean, you can paint it, you can put fabric on it. You just have to be careful because this motor can only take so much, it can only pull so much. So, I mean, it's not gonna be able to grab and pick up things, obviously. It's more for animatronics more than anything. But yeah. I like the beads because it's all one size. They're a little harder to thread. And one of the tutorials I saw on Robot Cardboard Hand suggested using rubber bands to bring the fingers back into place. Now this works, but they don't last very long because they're glued. I don't know if it, and I tried tape and they just snapped right back off. However, I'll show you the workaround for this. The best workaround I found was to actually use plastic zip ties. It's got enough bend to it to where it'll snap it back. And it's just a matter of gluing them on there. You don't need to have this. As you can see, it does keep its shape. And the fingers do snap back because it is cardboard and we have the joints. But if you want it to snap all the way back and be flat or in a certain position, you do need some sort of support. And on my other cardboard hand, it didn't bow anywhere in here. I mean, these lines may be a little too tight to where the cardboard is bowing. So you may actually want to double layer the cardboard on the arm portion, not necessarily the fingers. The fingers, you want them as thin as possible so the motor actually pulls the fingers. Just one more final note about the robot hands. If you make either of these or attempt either of these, I would love to see them, whether it's posting a picture or posting a video. I'd love to see what people come up with. That's kind of funny. This bend actually makes it wave. It's like,